Hi, I'm Corey. I'm a CPA and subject matter expert in financial accounting. And in this video, we're going to run through an overview of corporate distributions. We'll start off with a brief discussion to develop an understanding of what corporate distributions are. Next, we'll dive into a few of the different shapes and forms they can take. And finally, we'll tie it all together with some examples of how to account for them in the financial statements. Understanding how corporate distributions work is crucial for investors and the business as a whole. So let's dive right in. Have you ever invested in a company before? Maybe you bought shares through an investment brokerage or even used an app. Many companies will incentivize you to keep your investment with them by offering you some kind of reward. This reward can come in various shapes and sizes, things like cash, assets, or even additional shares in the organization. Essentially, the business is sharing its profits with the shareholders of the organization. Companies need to be strategic about how they choose to distribute these profits and develop an understanding of how it impacts the business and financial statements. Investors also need to understand their options when it comes to these corporate distributions so they can make smarter investment decisions in the long run. So now that we know what corporate distributions are, let's dive into some examples. One of the most common types of corporate distributions are dividends. Dividends usually refer to cash that a corporation pays to its shareholders at specific intervals throughout the year. Many companies choose to pay dividends quarterly to coincide with the release of their quarterly financial statements. However, dividends can be paid at other times as well. In order for dividends to be paid out, the board of directors usually must go through an approval process, where they review the current financial status of the organization and determine whether to declare the dividend. This dividend declaration date is extremely important in the accounting world, as this is when the obligation gets locked in, resulting in an accounting transaction, which impacts the financial statements. More on this a little bit later. If you're an investor, you're also watching this declaration date very closely, as this particular date can be the difference between more money in your pocket for that month. While not as common, companies also reward their investors with other types of dividends, including property dividends. Property dividends, also known as dividends in kind, are exactly as they sound. Instead of the company distributing cash to their investors, in this case, they provide them with another type of asset, such as real estate or inventory. Once the shareholder receives the physical asset, they can choose to sell it and convert it to cash or hold on to it for a long-term investment. Now, why would a company choose to issue a non-cash dividend? Well, there could be many reasons, but a common situation is that the company doesn't currently have the funds available to pay out cash dividends, but they still want to be able to compensate their shareholders. This can be an excellent option for all parties involved. A third category of capital distributions is the stock dividend. Instead of paying out a cash or property dividend, companies can choose to declare a stock dividend. This means that each shareholder will receive additional shares of the company's stock in direct proportion to their current ownership stake. Let's say a company decides to issue 100 stock dividends, and you currently own 5% of the company's shares. In this case, you would receive 5 additional new shares. So now that we understand the various forms that corporate distributions can take, we need to be aware that not all dividends are paid out equally. When it comes to the shares in a company, all corporations have common stock. However, some corporations also have another category called preferred stock. In this case, preferred shareholders are entitled to certain benefits, one of them being that they must receive their dividends before the common shareholders. Another common misconception is that dividends are an expense to the company. This is not the case, since they are not part of the company's regular course of operations and have no impact on the profit reported in the income statement. Instead of an expense, we can think of dividends as a distribution of these profits to the shareholders. Let's look at an example of how corporate distributions are handled in the financial statements. When corporate distributions are made, where would we see the primary impact within a company's financial records? If you said the balance sheet, you were right. Since dividends are paid out of the company's retained earnings, whenever this happens, we would expect to see a decrease to the owner's equity section of the balance sheet. In this example, notice the opening balance of retained earnings is $505,000. Then let's say the company reviews this balance and decides to declare a quarterly cash dividend of $55,000 on June 30. On that declaration date, we would see the following accounting journal. First, we would see a debit or decrease to the company's retained earnings of $55,000. We would also see a corresponding credit or increase to their dividends payable liability, since this money is now owed to their shareholders. We can now see the decrease in the company's retained earnings on the balance sheet as it dropped from $505,000 down to $450,000. However, remember at this time, there still has been no impact to cash. Fast forward to the next month when the cash actually changes hands. This is when the cash account is impacted. At this time, there would be an additional entry in the accounting records where we clear out the liability with a debit to the dividends payable account and see a corresponding $55,000 decrease to the company's cash account. And with that, all of the accounting entries related to this particular corporate distribution are now complete and are accounted for within the financial statements. And that brings us to the end of this video. It's clear that corporate distributions can have a significant impact to both a company's financial reporting as well as their ability to generate investment in the organization. Understanding this topic gives companies the tools they need to thrive, while also providing investors with the ability to make smarter investment decisions. While we just skimmed the surface here in this video, if you're interested in learning more, please feel free to check out our additional videos on many more related topics.